Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can count how many vowel and consonants are present in a string using dynamic memory location. Before starting, you can note how you can search my YouTube channel. You can type my name Sanjay Gupta in YouTube search bar. My channel will be available on first page. You can find out various programming related videos and playlists there. You can also download my programming app Tachymiz, which is available on Google Play. Now I am going to implement solution of this problem. So first I am including a header file, that is stdio.h. Now I am including a header file, that is stdlib.h. Then I am defining main function. Here I am declaring integer variables, that is n, c1 and c2. C1, c2 are initialized with 0. Then I am declaring a character pointer, which is p. Now to receive size of string, I am going to display a message through printf, enter size of string. To read that size from user, I am applying scanf, and the entered size will be stored inside n variable. Now I am going to allocate dynamic memory. For that I am calling malloc function. So malloc function is responsible for dynamic memory allocation. Here n into size of char, through this multiplication the size of memory will be allocated, and the base address will be returned, that will be typecasted into character pointer and will be stored inside p pointer. Now through p pointer I can access all the locations of that memory location. So first I am going to print a message, that is enter string. And user will enter a particular string that will be stored in p pointer through getS. So before getS, I have to call fflush function, and I am passing standard in this function. So fflush function will clear the buffer, because after reading integers, if I want to read characters, then I have to clean the buffer memory. Then I can call getS, and I am passing p inside it. So the entered string will be stored inside p pointer. Now with the help of a loop, I can count how many vowel or consonants are available in a string. So I am declaring one more variable, that is I am initializing I with 0. Now I am implementing while loop. And while loop having this condition, asterisk p plus I not equals to null. So p plus I will be pointing to a location, or you can say to a location's address, and that address will be dereferenced with this asterisk sign. So the available value will be checked whether it is equals to null or not. So if it is not equals to null, then loop will be repeated, otherwise it will be terminated. So inside this while loop I can write if asterisk p plus I double equals to a. Now I am copying this expression, and with OR operator I am pasting it. So here e, then OR, then I, then again OR, then O, OR, U. So this way I have implemented the complete expression in front of you, which is checking whether the address is containing a, e, I, o, u or not. So if it is containing a, e, I, o, u, it means the content is vowel, otherwise it is consonant. And here I am only focusing upon uppercase letters. So according to me, the entered characters will be only uppercase letters. If you want to check lowercase also, then you have to type these expressions 5 times more for lowercase letters. So here I am incrementing c1, and in else part I am incrementing c2, and then i++. So this way I have implemented the logic in front of you. After completion of this loop, I can print the quantities vowel equals to %d slash n, consonants equals to %d, then c1 comma c2. Then I can call free function that will deallocate dynamically allocated memory, and then return 0. So this way I have implemented complete logic in front of you, which is checking how many vowels and consonants are present in a string using dynamic memory allocation. So here it is asking for the size of string. So I am entering 6 as input and I am entering India. So you can see the output. Vowels are 3 and consonants are 2. So in India, 3 vowels are available, that is I, I, A, and N and D. These two letters are consonants. So the output is correct. Program is working properly. So here you can see I have implemented dynamic memory allocation for a string and I have counted vowels and consonants that are available in a string. I hope you have understood the logic well. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can search my YouTube channel by typing my name Sanjay Gupta in YouTube search bar. Here various programming related videos are available. Thank you for watching this video.